Hello and thanks for tuning in. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. If you're returning, thanks. It means a lot. All right, we're back at the Ram 3500 turbo diesel, and I wanted to look at some issues with the cooling system and how we're going to address them. So we're going to go up under the engine compartment now, and a common issue that we see here is the flattened upper radiator hose, and you see how it's sucked, literally sucked thin right here. I mean, it's got such a vacuum on it, it's ridiculous. So there is a solution for this. We're gonna get everything out and laid out, and I'm going to probably end up changing that thermostat to a 180 T-stat because this truck is deleted. So let me get all the items laid out and let's get to the install. This is with the 200 degree thermostat, 57 degrees out. It runs between 195 and 200. Well, basically 190 and 200 bounces between there when you're driving. Dodge had a tech tip that you could change these thermostats to 190, but seeing as it's deleted and tuned, I am no longer needing the high temperatures in my engine, and that's why we're going to the 180. So let's get everything laid out and put in. Okay, and as we can see now, after a drive, the thermostat hose is nice and round. When it cools down, it'll suck back down, and I don't like that. So let's get this thing changed out. Is let the motor cool down, take the radiator cap off, and open the drain valve and drain down some coolant below the upper radiator hose so that we can get the hose and thermostat housing off. All right, after draining about a gallon of coolant down, we're gonna come up and take off the two band clamps on the upper radiator hose here, and you can squeeze it to make sure it's empty. Let's get those clamps off and get this hose off. We got the stock hose off, and you can see it's clear off there. Let's get the thermostat housing off, and you can see still steam coming off because I just sprayed it down with water because coolant got in the belt and I didn't feel like having the belt get all sticky. So let's get this thermostat housing off. It's 3 8mm bolts, I believe, or 5/16ths. And we'll just pull it straight off. Now, you may have a harder time because you may have an EGR tube here. I don't, so it's very easy for me. But if you do, I believe you gotta remove that EGR tube to change the thermostat. But don't quote me on that. Thermostat housing off. Don't forget to disconnect your turbo coolant feed line. And let's go over and look at the other thermostats. So this is the original Cummins one that I pulled off. It's a 200 degree, kind of dirty looking. Going back with a Murray Plus, it's a 180, so it's a 20 degree difference. Only difference is the placement of the air bleeders in here. Those are on each side and this is on one side. So we'll drop the thermostat back in, get the housing back on, and we'll take a look at the new coolant pipe. There it is. The Sinister Diesel upper radiator hose, solid metal. I believe it might be steel, I'm not sure. I think it's steel, mild steel. But we'll get it on there, comes with great clamps. And new silicone hoses to attach to the radiator and the thermostat housing. So let's get this thing on and see how it looks. Okay, there it is installed. Looks beautiful. It's a very tight fit as far as getting hoses on and those clamps. As you see, I have the threaded part towards the valve cover away from the fan. And these facing this way away from the hood for when I close it. We'll get it filled up and we'll go for a test drive and see what the temps are. A few degrees colder outside, but I don't think that has any effect on the coolant temperature because the engine, once it gets up to operating temperature, everything's heat soaked. I didn't see temperatures over 190 and I was boosting 34 pounds throttle to the floor. So definitely an improvement here. I'm gonna step out, open the hood, and show you guys one issue I found with the clamp that Sinister sent me. All right, the clamp that went onto the thermostat housing was definitely too big and it leaked coolant, so I had to go back with the factory stock clamp. I will call Sinister tomorrow and see what the deal is, and see if they'll send me out a new one, and I'll change it eventually. But yeah, definitely a nice upgrade for the truck. Pipe gets warm. Just be careful with it. No leaks, no nothing. Everything works good. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe.